paint as innovation inspired by nature. Nature is our vast resource for a more efficient and sustainable future. Studying the way nature solves problems provides us with a lot of solutions. After a lot of research on selecting a natural concept, finally it was decided on a very interesting creature called Namibian fog basking beetle. The Namibian fog basking beetle lives in one of the driest deserts in the world and has adapted in the most efficient manner. Let me share with you an interesting talk by Michael Pollan about this fascinating creature.
And if you look at some of the organisms that have evolved to live in deserts, there are some amazing examples of adaptations to water scarcity. This is the Namibian fog basking beetle, and has evolved a way of harvesting its own fresh water in a desert. The way it does this is it comes out at night, crawls to the top of a sand dune, and because it's got a matte black shell, it's able to radiate heat out to the night sky and become slightly cooler than its surroundings. So when the moist breeze blows in off the sea, you get these droplets of water forming on the beetle's shell. Just before sunrise, tips its shell up, water runs down to its mouth, has a good drink, goes off and hides the rest of the day. And the ingenuity, if you could call it that, goes even further. Because if you look closely at the beetle's shell, there are lots of little bumps on that shell. And those bumps are hydrophilic. They attract water. And between them, there's a waxy finish which repels water. And the effect of this is that as the droplets start to form on the bumps, they stay in tight spherical beads, which means they're much more mobile than they would be if it was just a film of water over the whole beetle's shell. So even when there's only a small amount of moisture in the air, it's still able to harvest that very effectively and channel it down to its mouth. So an amazing example of an adaptation to a very resource-constrained environment. And in that sense, very relevant to the kind of challenges we're going to be facing over the next few years, next few decades.
Further study of the anatomy of the beetle showed that its abdomen is covered by four wings called elytra, which provides armored offenses while maintaining flexibility. It was also observed that its hind legs were elongated compared to the others of its kind. The internal morphology showed that the beetle has a tracheal respiratory system where air enters through spiracles. Another interesting internal morphology was that the beetle had an open circulatory system. Keeping these in mind, five interesting features of the beetle were adopted. They are 1. Its compound eyes, 2. Diffused elytra, 3. Spiracles for respiration, 4. Tilt and body orientation, and 5. Water collection mechanism. The next question was, where do I adopt these mechanisms for maximum benefit? The case study opted was the CNC Alpha Utilities desalination plant located in Sharjah. The climatic condition is hot and arid. Main attention is given to the main shed where there are 20 workers working at a time. The plant keeps running 24 hours a day. The occupants in this plant experience very low comfort levels. Design strategies derived from the Namibian fog basking beetle were adopted to optimize the comfort level at the desalination plant. Strategy 1. To introduce daylight into the building using light wells with high impact dome and diffuser. Poor lighting levels were observed at the main shed and the plant had artificial lights. Light wells would help in providing diffuse light to the area. This was inspired by compound eyes of the beetle. By comparing results from the Ecotech daylight analysis, we can conclude that huge savings of about 21.9 megawatt hour per annum can be made. Strategy 2. Use of photovoltaic cells in the right latitude angle and uplifting them for most efficiency. This was inspired by the tilt of the body of the beetle using its large extremities to collect water efficiently. huge savings up to 18.25 megawatt hour per annum can be made. Strategy 3. Comfort ventilation by use of soffit vents, ridge vents, gable vents and turbine fans. This was inspired by the use of spiracles in the respiratory system. This would increase the airflow in the building. As illustrated, a steady airflow would increase the comfort level of the occupants. Strategy 4. Evaporative cooling methods to enhance the comfort inside the desalination plant. This was inspired by the water collection mechanism of the Namibian fog basking beetle. The high internal heat load produced by machines cannot be sufficiently reduced by natural ventilation alone. The temperature in the building can reach as high as 40 degrees Celsius if the outside temperature is more than 30 degrees Celsius. Working conditions can be intolerable for people who work there. Evaporative cooling can help to deal with this situation. Evaporative coolers can lower the temperature by as much as 10 degrees Celsius. The principle of evaporative cooling is as simple as it is effective. There is an exchange of energy as the warm air flows past the moist absorption medium. The water evaporates, thereby cooling the air down. The warmer the incoming air, the greater the cooling effect. The filter is kept continuously moist by water circulation system. The cooling modules can be installed as needed. As an option, it can be fitted with high efficiency AC fans. Has a low running cost and reduces carbon footprint, making it more sustainable. By incorporating these strategies in the desalination plant, we can increase the comfort level of the occupants and create a more sustainable way of living. Let's create a world where the environment doesn't need protecting.